In this video, I'm going to walk you through how to fill out the DV Lottery 2022 yourself for free. Hello everybody and welcome to the channel once again. Thank you so much for clicking on this video. If you're new here, please hit on the subscribe button. If you're old here, thank you so much. So the most frequently asked question this year is, do you require or do you need a passport before you can fill out this form? I believe by the end of this video, you will get to understand and you get to know what to do. So we're going to use about four websites over here. Each of them pretty much has something very important in playing a role. The first one is this particular website, the dvprogram.states.gov. I'll leave all links in the description in case you want to follow any of them. Now, this is the particular website that we're going to use to fill the form. It contains pretty much everything from the DV instructions, from the photo examples, and of course beginning the entry. And even if you applied for 2021, you can check your status over here. Now, when you click on this DV instructions, it will take you to the second website, which is the travel.state.government. Now, the second website here contains the instructions. So when you click on this particular DV22 program instructions, it will take you straight away to this PDF file that I've saved or that I have over here. And you have to make sure that you read through all this because it contains pretty much all the instructions that you need to fill these forms. I can't cover everything in the video. So if you take time to read the PDF, it is going to be of so much help to you. And then the final website that we consider is the egreencardphoto.com, which is the website that we use to crop out the picture, the perfect picture size for the entry, because at a point in time we are going to be asked to submit a particular picture, and this website is going to help you to check it out. And let me add this quick one. This is the dvlottery.me photo checker. After you've cropped your picture, you can actually place your picture in here to check whether the requirement is met, because you can crop the picture out here, all right, but then this particular website is going to give you a clear idea whether your picture has met the actual requirement. With that said, let's get back to the dvprogram.state.government. Go to the begin entry here and let's get started. Trust me, this is going to be very simple and you don't have to pay anyone to do this for you. So click on the begin entry here and it will take you to the next step. My internet may be very slow, so you have to just bear with me. Now, this is the beginning. So the first thing that you need to do is you need to authenticate this code, and right over here you have to put in this one. Mind you, this is all in caps, so you have to be very careful not to type it. It is very key sensitive, I must say. So I'm going to type this one. Let's see if I'm right over there. And then you're going to click on submit. If what you type in is very correct, it is going to take you to this next page, which contains the form. If it isn't, you're going to have to retype everything that came out there. Or if you can't see, actually, you can click on that reshuffle button at the right, extreme right, to see the next one and try it out. So this is the form that we're going to fill. This is not case sensitive. You can fill in caps or smaller keys. It is absolutely not case sensitive. So you start right from here, from your family name to your first name, middle name. Okay, so let's start. And in this video, I'm going to use my friend's name. So I'm going to start with the first, or the family name, that is a Siedu here. And then the first name is going to be Hannah. And if you don't have any middle name, all that you need to do is go ahead and take no middle name, just like that. The next one, your gender, you're going to pick the gender over here. Now, to the date of birth, over here, you don't need to write 4th and January as in alphabet. You just have to type if the month is 04, like I've inputted over there. All that you need to do is type 04 here. That is April, right? So if it is May, you're going to type 05. And if the day is something like 11th, or let's say 25th, I'm just going for random days and then the year here you're going to type, say 1996. This place is the most important one. You don't need to type January and all those stuff. Just put in the figures and then you're good to go. Now the city where you are born, this is going to be very simple. I've already typed it over here, so Kumasi, and then you're going to type in like that, so Kumasi. Now if you don't know your birth city, it isn't a problem, just take birth city or no, and then you move to the next one, the country where you were born. Now to the country where you were born, this is the original country where you were born and not where you were living, so I'm going to pick Ghana for this one. And then your country of eligibility. So here is where the confusion sets in. So you see here, your country of eligibility will normally be the same as your country of birth. So your country of eligibility, you can check the instructions to see first over here when it comes to the instructions over here. And then you come to the requirements number one here, you see eligibility, so you can check for the list of countries that are not eligible. So it means that if you apply from with that particular country's passport, you not be taken into consideration. So you may be living in Ghana but you were born in Nigeria, which probably means Nigeria is not eligible, so you can't apply. So you must take note. In the same way, you may be living in a country that is ineligible, so your country of eligibility is not related to where you live now. I come from Ghana but I'm living in Nigeria and I want to apply for the DV lottery. Since I'm from Ghana where Ghana is eligible but I'm living in Nigeria which is ineligible, it still means that I can apply and choose Ghana as my country of eligibility. So basically your country of eligibility, like it says here, is probably your country of birth. So you have to check first whether your country of birth is eligible for the DV program. So here, are you claiming eligibility based on the country where you were born? And you're going to take yes. And if you are yes, you just proceed because it will take this into action. If you choose no, you have to go for the country, the other country. And then you can click on this link here to get more explanation on the country of eligibility. Now to the most asked question, do you require or do you need a passport? And it's clear from here, yes, you need a passport this year, and that is what changes basically from the previous years. You need a passport before you can apply for this year's DV lottery. So you're going to input your name, your first name, middle name, your passport number, the expiration date, and your passport shouldn't be expired. Even if it is left with one day for it to expire, as at the day that you are filling, you are good to go. And in the same way, you may be having a passport but it is expired, you can't use it. And since these passport numbers and dates and all these are very critical, I'm not going to try to type anything here. If you have your passport, you can just go ahead and input. Just make sure that everything is in place and then you choose your country of issuance. And of course, there are exemptions to the passports, and these are the exemptions. If you don't have any nationality, you don't know exactly where you were born, a national or communist controlled country, so you can read the exemptions to the passport. If you don't fit to any of these three requirements here, that means that you must present a passport before you can proceed. Now the next one is the entrant photo, and when it comes to the DV section over here, I think at number 7, okay, that is it from here. So when you go to the PDF, you have to read about all of this one, and I took time to make a full video in case you want to check. Link will be in the description. So if you are able to follow all these instructions here, and it is very, very important, you have to take very, very, very critical look at this place. It is very important. At the end of the day, you should have a picture like what I'll be uploading. So if you are able to follow all the instructions from here, use this particular green card photo to crop it out, check for the eligibility. And by checking, this is what I mean, you have to click on this particular link here, upload your photo. So on my desktop I have this picture, and this is what I used in the video of how I showed you how to crop the picture. So you double click on it like that, and then it is going to give you a feedback. So you can see from here that the photo checker result, the file size is correct, the image height correct, head size, eyes are located, and then the background looks good. So for instance, if you have like a gray background, a black background, this particular website is going to tell you that your background doesn't look good, or your background is not correct and it's going to be in red. And also, let's say if the file size is too big, it is going to tell you. If you don't position your head size correctly and your eyes aren't located within the proper range, it is also going to tell you. So this particular website at least is going to make sure that you have your picture well cropped out, though it isn't 100% that you're going to win when you have your picture like this one, but at least it is good to use it to check your picture. So after checking everything here, you can go back to your DV lottery and you go to choose photo over here, and you're going to navigate to where you have your picture and upload it like that. So your picture should show over here. Now at the end of the day, when you submit your entry, if the picture is not correct, the size is not correct, it is also going to tell you, so you know what to do. Now back to the mailing address. This is in care of. If you are using someone else's PO box address, you're going to use in care of the either the church, school, or the person's name, and then the address line one is going to be the actual box, which is probably say PO box 7 or 6. Let me use 6 for this one. Address line 2 is optional, you're just going to leave it. The city or town must come, so Kumasi, and then the district, county, or province or state, I'm going to use Kumasi Metropolitan over here. So you can use your district, or let's say your county or province or state. And then the zip code, if you are living in Ghana for instance, you can use 00233, or if you don't want to put yourself in trouble, just choose no postal code over here. And then the country is going to be Ghana, because we don't have any official postal or zip code. So the next thing is the country where you live today, and that one is simple, you choose Ghana. The mobile number is optional, you can decide whether you want to type it in or not. Your email address is mandatory, so I'm going to use hannah@gmail.com. okay, so hannah@gmail.com. now this email is very important. Read this. This email address will be used to provide you with additional information if you are selected, so you have to make sure you don't make a mistake with this one. Now to your highest level of education, and that one too, I'll plead with you to read the instructions on the highest level of education or the working experience. So in my case, I'm going to choose some graduate level courses because I'm still in the university, or the person is still in the university, he or she hasn't graduated yet. Now in case you don't have anything related to school, you can use this particular website to check whether your occupation qualifies for a DV lottery. And we move on to the last sections, so your current marital status, and if you are married with children, you're going to provide the names and information for all of them. So in this case, I'm going to choose a married, and the number is 0, the number of children is 0. Once you're done with all of this, you can go back to your form and check whether you typed in everything correctly, and if everything sounds or seems okay for you, all that you need to do is click continue over here. Now since I left some spaces, especially the part of the passport blank, it means that I can't continue. But if you follow this video carefully and you typed in everything as correct, you should be taken to a second page where you're going to verify all your information, and if everything sounds okay for you, you're going to submit it. You can refer to the video that I did in 2018 about the next page and the confirmation code. At the end of everything, when you submit, you should have a confirmation code, something similar to what I'm displaying on the screen right now, and that is going to be kind of your ticket or your receipt, your evidence in case you win. That is the confirmation number that you're going to input in to claim your win. So that's pretty much it for the forms. That's basically everything that you need to know about this. Be sure to hit me up with any questions, if you have any concerns with pictures, with any of the explanations that you didn't get in the comment section, and I'll be glad to assist in any way possible. Thank you so much for sticking around to watch this video, and good luck to everyone who will be applying this year. I'll get back to you with another video. It's Innocent here, and bye.